And hello YouTube, I'm back. I don't know if it's been a few seconds or a day, but hey, I'm back. Let's continue.
I think I'm all played out for tonight.
Chipmunk.
Ducky. Hope he's doing okay. Riley probably can't help me hack Typhon.
Yeah, not so much.
Yep. The tables seem to have turned, all right. Looks like I'm on my own now. I don't want to drag Ryan and Stefan any deeper.
Oh, for real? Is that what that means? Oh, because I didn't take his fear?
This isn't over, Gabe. I promise.
Okay. Must make different choices next time. Every different choice.
I guess the night wasn't all bad.
Facts. Kissed a girl. She liked it. You liked it.
Can't wait to have nightmares tonight. I look better than I feel.
Alright, changing my outfit. Although I look really good in that skirt.
Might as well go talk to Jed now.
Let me double check. That's the only outfit I get to wear.
Maybe I'll just bike out to the mine. Dig up some answers myself.
Yeah, that sounds safe.
Feels like the LARP was 100 years ago. Hey, Jed.
There she is. Have a seat. Something tells me you've had a more exciting spring festival than you planned for.
You saw Pike arrest me.
And let you go, apparently. Then there's that business with Ryan and Steph earlier today. I wasn't sure why it took all three of you to work out Diane's lunch order. I know you're used to looking out for yourself. Gabe was like that. But Haven's a community. We help each other. I want to help you. But first, you have to let me know what's going on.
Fuck it. What have I got to lose?
Facts.
Typhon killed Gabe. I have proof.
What proof?
I stole it from Diane. Emails and documents proving there was a second explosion the night Gabe died. To cover something up, Jed. Some secret they buried. I don't know what it is. I don't even know what to do next. But I'm not giving up. Not ever.
I know what they're hiding.
Wait, what?
Please, Jed. What's the truth? What are they afraid of?
Typhon's the devil that runs this town. I've been carrying their secrets for far too long. I know what they buried in the mountains.
Tell me.
I'll do one better. I'll show you.
Okay.
There, up ahead.
Where are we?
Middle of nowhere. About two clicks that way is the...
Hold on, I need to turn my backlights off. There's a glare on this dark scene and... I don't like it. Turn those off real quick.
Mining site where you search for Ethan. Five clicks that way is town.
What is this thing?
Ventilation shaft. They're scattered everywhere. Over the years, mines grow into mines, creating a labyrinth under Haven. What you're searching for is down below.
Wait, what? You're gonna make her go down? That's not safe.
Why are you sad?
No. Are you fucking serious, Jed? He's working for Typhon?
I'm sorry, kid.
Okay. Just put the gun down.
I tried to talk you out of it. Scare you off? I was sure those pictures of Ryan and Steph would do the trick.
Oh my god.
But you were relentless. Won't leave damn well enough alone.
You don't have to do this.
I do. 12 years ago, I made a mistake. The kind of thing that you can't undo. But Typhon made me a deal.
What?
A way to save my town. Give my boy a normal life. I never wanted Gabe to get hurt.
Go to hell.
Oh my god. What the fuck? Are you serious right now? Kind of thing you can't undo. That was a quick chapter. What the actual fuck? I convince Alex to sign. Oh, I'm in the minority on that one. Yeah, majority gave it to Steph. Nice. Alex didn't sit on the bonfire? Or sit at the bonfire? I didn't know I could. And I didn't sit on the couch. Alright. Mused about moving to Salem. Pretty even spread around there. Seven Alex Jetticus. Yeah. Ryan didn't eat meat. Alex on the rooftop. I don't want to read the other options because I want to play through on that one. Charlotte felt weirdly detached at the festival. Alex didn't find Riley at the bus stop. Oh, I could have gone and done that? Shit. Alex didn't use her power with Ducky. Oh. Alex helped the jelly bean counter. Alex didn't talk to the diner buyer. Alex didn't help them admit their feelings. Damn, I missed a lot in that chapter. Fuck. I really didn't expect Jed to be a fucking secret douchebag. Chapter 5, Side B. What the fuck? What's happening right now?
Welcome back, Alex. Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado? Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
It's a The whole fucking town's corrupt?
I learned to let myself feel, I guess. And to not be afraid of those feelings.
Couldn't one argue that those old fears turned out to be justified? What do you make of that friction? I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery. Got to kiss a pretty girl. But Alex, you're right back where you started.
What?
You're wrong. I don't belong in here.
If that were true, Alex, you'd know you were talking to an empty chair.
Wait, what?
What the fuck?
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm thinking right now.
Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Alex Chen?
Never heard
my
of
guitar
her.
Case has never heard of me. Sure.
What?
Huh.
A 5-digit code. How are you feeling today? Angry, scared, sad, lonely, happy, guilty. Excuse me.
Is that what I look like? Really? These don't belong. Dr. Lin. A tuning peg.
Huh? Phone? Dr. Lin, in light of all the recent excitement, now is a good time to remind Helping Hands residents that impulses to leave our institution while understandable, well, and are best resisted. Remember, the outside world is sharp-toothed and possessed of an insatiable hunger, and you are soft and slow and appetizing. Why throw yourself into its mouth? Throw yourself instead into me. Oh, that sounds naughty. I'm just saying. That sounds really bad. Innuendo! Oh, now there's more.
How did I even get back here?
Attention residents, please join me in welcoming Alex Chen back to Helping Hands. We're happy, though not surprised, that Alex has once more submitted herself to this stultifying and inescapable embrace of our institution. ISO, one missing patient. Answers to Alex, she was always scratching at the door trying to get out, but she's declawed, so her capacity to fend for herself is minimal. If spotted, please exercise caution when approaching. She will appear friendly and normal. We've had some behavioral issues in the past. Please help me find my patient. I'm starting to get really worried. A take? Thank you. Oh yeah, we're definitely in a mindscape right now.
Dr. Lin always recorded our... records our sessions.
Dark anymore, so I can turn my lights back on. I'm going with a darker color though. I think red is appropriate right now.
Guess that's me. Case number 53322.
Five-digit number, 53322. Emotional instability, occasionally violent outbursts, hallucinations, visual hallucinations, oral, delusional, ideation, depression, anxiety. No diagnosis.
Thrown down a... what?
Alex experiences a detailed and robust delusion that she is able to read other people's emotional states and believes that because of this ability, she is uniquely equipped to help others overcome their own emotional trauma. It's difficult to overlook the irony. Someone as profoundly dysfunctional as Alex, adopting the role of emotional caretaker. Had she not been returned to my care, I do not think it hyperbolic to speculate that her reckless attempts at fixing her friends and family would eventually have gotten someone hurt. It's my belief that Alex's delusions constitute a threat to her continued well-being as well as those of others. As such, I recommend Alex be thrown down an endless pit, body shattered against each jutting board and errant brick until she is forgotten in the darkness beneath the world. This is, in my professional opinion, the most humane thing we can do for her. What? 53322.
Gabe gave me this guitar, but he never heard me play it.
Oh shit. Am I not dead? Just really fucked up? Freddy, shoot me. Wow, I survived that? Are you fucking serious? Ah. Oh, I didn't fall all the way down. Maybe that's why.
Oh!
You got some serious injuries, girl. Or did he not even hit you with this bullet? Or did he just shoot near you to make you fall? Careful. Oh, fuck. Yep. The heck into our brainscape again. Hello?
Psst. Alex.
What the? What's up, dude?
Gabe? You're dead.
So? Lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
I want to say a hospital.
Dr. Mendez to intensive care. Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Yep, definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick. So is our father, but it's a different kind of sickness. Play your part.
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. She was right over there, waiting for me.
Okay.
We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. There it is. The painting that taught me that art sucked sometimes. Gabe and I used to watch cartoons on this thing after school. Mom used to fidget with her keys whenever she was worried.
Gabe? Alex? I need you to listen very carefully. We got some scary news today. And I'm going to be spending some time at the hospital.
What? Mom? Are you okay?
Hush now. It's going to be okay. Do you understand me? Things will be different for a little while. But I am going to be okay.
We spent so much time in here that I basically memorized every article. Gabe told me it was full of needles. Scared me to death. It was always too hot in this room. She's just on the other side. How many nights did Dad spend in this room? Sleeping in an uncomfortable chair and eating vending machine dinners. There's something so weird and scary about watching your dad cry. Mom. Every time I saw her, I worried it would be the last. Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that how it went? You don't think you missed anything?
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Bruh.
Excuse me.
Okay.
Why are we booping right now?
Wait. Did I miss something?
The water wasn't there before.
No matter how much Mom drank, her throat was always dry.
What?
Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Weird how somebody else coughing can sometimes make you cough.
Get her some water.
Thank you. You almost never cried, even when you were very small. Did you know that? That's been my biggest challenge with you. How do you take care of someone who is already so strong? My strong girl. I want you to make me a promise.
Dude, super inappropriate time to scream. This is a serious moment. Come on. But you're going, yeah. I honestly debated whether or not to disable the sound bites for this playthrough, to be honest. Dental appointment? I fear the dentist. Well, hopefully it goes well. Make sure you bring all your consoles so you can do updates and downloads on free Wi-Fi. That's the plan. Yeah, I figured.
Your brother. Your father. They are going to need you. You have to be strong. Will you do that, Alex?
It's all good, man. At least it keeps me from crying, so.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
What? Good, you should get it. It's awesome so far. I think I might actually get a tattoo out of this game. We'll see. There's a couple of images in here that I like, and this game is good enough for me to have that lasting memory. Again, it all depends on how it ends. It's Shushu.
Was that the last time you talked to her? Mom.
I think so.
Do you miss her?
Of course.
Gabe, what's going on?
You're 11, I'm almost 15. Dad and I are time bombs. You keep running back and forth, trying to defuse us both.
Play your part.
This is going to suck so bad. Play your part.
Volume dial was my best friend on days like this.
song. I think I do.
My tea's gone yep. Cold, I'm wondering why.
Exactly where I thought it was.
Got out of bed at all. The morning rain clouds up my window. And I can't see it all. And even if I could, it'd all be gray. Put your picture on my wall.
Alex?
It's okay, it's just me. But you know that's not how it went down, right?
Stan? No, it's Gabe. Oh, I don't know the name of the song. I just know the song.
It was my job to keep the peace. But no matter what I did, Gabe had barely used this backpack in weeks. Nobody could get him to go to school.
There's no way that song's by Eminem. Nope. Uh-uh. That was a female voice. Come on. Try harder.
Mom and Dad had this TV before they had either of us. I tried so hard to keep my promise to her. This was probably the most expensive thing we owned. It kind of kept me sane.
All right, fine. I will. Stan by Eminem.
Here are some details.
Dido. That's the voice. Yeah, see, I equate that to Dido. Apparently the artist is Eminem, though. That's insane. Oh, come on. Commercials go away. I hate advertisements. Oh my god, go away, shut up. Blah 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 blah. I'm gonna mute real quick because this could be copyrighted. Okay, I think the radio version of it, I never heard his voice in it. Apparently there's a 8-minute long version that has him talking in the background. Yeah, the female is Dido, D-I-D-O. Like, I've listened to her music before. That's who I equated that song to back when it was popular. Because there's a version of that song. It's just her singing it. It's just Dido. There's no Eminem. That thing was on the radio constantly. But yeah, I had no clue that that was also Eminem. So hey, I learned a new thing. Oh, it's that song. Yeah. It's not so bad. I've heard this song so many times in the past. Never once did I hear the version with Eminem in it. This shit was on a radio and everything. And then you call me and it's not so bad. It's not so bad. I wanna thank you. Yep. Thank you the best day. I think this song was the original. And then Eminem used it in a video called Stan. Cause that was like a music video where he like talked and stuff. I only watched like a few seconds of it, but I could tell. YouTube's definitely gonna copyright claim that. Hopefully it won't block my video or make me delete the audio.
All right.
But yeah, yeah, I know Dido. That's who I know. She had
the
a lot of
killer mistress tabs in this book weren't even close to right.
Okay.
Gabe loved Son of Lead back when it was an indie. It was too gory for me.
Gory comics, let's go.
Cleaning Dad's ashtray was not my favorite job in the world. At least I managed to hold on to you, Shushu.
Shushu.
Dad's laundry. I always set it here when it was done so he could find it. Mom's old sewing kit. Don't think I've ever even tasted a butter cookie. It was full of greeting cards. Mom kept every single one we ever got. Thanks for trying, Lucky Cat. My job was to sort them in order of how close we were to a collections notice.
That's tough.
I wanted to be a werewolf that Halloween. Couldn't afford the costume. I can't believe they were ever this happy. Gabe used to steal Dad's beer all the time. It was like the one thing they didn't fight about.
Dude, if my son drank my beer, I would kick his fucking ass. Although, he's not the kind of person. He's like the kind of kid that's like, yeah, I don't think I'm ever gonna drink. And I'm like, all right, cool. Respect.
We never really touched these after Mom died. She was such a good cook. 2 cups water for 1 cup rice. Set timer for 30 minutes. Do your history homework. Serve.
I have a new rice cooker. I haven't used it yet. I need to find a reason to use it.
Almost empty. Almost always.
Damn.
I didn't even know what CPS was. Just that I was afraid of them.
Child Protective Services.
Hey, Gabe. I'm Leslie Halloran. I'm from the Oregon State Child Protective Services. We got a call from someone who said there might have been some kind of fight here last night. Is your dad home?
Oh, gosh. You know what? We were... that was like, rehearsal. And I'm in this play at school. And my dad, like, he was, helping me learn my lines.
Must be some play. But if you need anything, my number is on there. Okay.
Damn. I not go upstairs?
Nope.
All right. That means I gotta do what I gotta do down here. Door.
Gabe and Dad were so loud when they fought.
Where are you going? Are you gonna tell her? Or is that my job?
Keep your voice down.
Fine. I'll do it. Alex, Dad lost his job. Again. So we're broke. Again.
Don't talk to me that way. Despite what you may believe, you do not know everything. You think what? I laid myself off?
It's okay. We'll figure it out. I could,
I don't know, Dad. But what are we supposed to do now? We gotta eat.
We can sell some records. Or what about my guitar? We can sell that.
Alex, what is it gonna take to get you to stop defending him?
Your mother could see you now.
I don't want to hear about Mom.
Gabe!
I'm so tired of you using her as an excuse to be a piece of shit. Don't fucking touch me, piece of shit!
Dad.
Damn it. Alex!
I'm okay. It's okay. It was an accident.
Alex, I didn't...
Dad! Dad, it's okay. Really, I'm not hurt.
Wow.
I can't do this.
Dad?
Did he just up and leave?
Someone will come. That woman from CPS. Someone.
Who fucking abandons their kids?
I'm sorry.
Like, literally abandons them with nobody else to take care of them. That's not a good thing. It's one thing to abandon your children knowing the other parent's gonna take care of them. I mean, that's still fucking shitty as hell, but to abandon your children when you know there's nobody else gonna take care of them? Have fun burning in hell forever. Thanks. That's crazy. Look at that eye movement. Oh my god, this game is amazing. Excuse me. Tried to write letters to him.
Hey, can I ask you a question? Which orphanage is this? The one in Grant Park? Kind of thought it'd be nicer.
I can't do this, okay? I can't.
You need to.
No.
You need to be honest about what you see.
I was. I have. And now I'm done.
Ow.
Elbow. Almost. But not yet. You are 12. I am 16. I steal a car and end up in juvie.
Gabe, wow. Come on.
Then you're 13, 14, 15. Orphanages, group homes, musty rooms in the strange houses of foster parents. By the time you're 17, you've seen them all. Somewhere along the line, you start to feel things. Your own emotions don't belong to you. You have nothing. No one. You are alone.
I don't want this.
Alex.
Oh shit.
Play your part.
Play my part.
Wow.
I used to write one every day. Stupid.
Why? You clearly missed him.
And I thought he missed me. Hence, stupid. Guess I missed a few days.
Happiness is a choice you make every day.
You okay?
How you holding up, Shu?
Can't believe how long you've had that thing.
That thing was my only friend after you left. We weren't allowed to bring glass into the dorms, so we had to drink from this thing.
Like hamsters in a cage.
Except if you give a hamster a glass, they don't toss it at the other hamsters' heads.
Pretty sure it's locked.
Must be after curfew. We're not going anywhere. God, they put me on so many meds.
Damn.
Did any of them ever work?
Some of them helped, a little. None of them fixed me.
In their defense, mutant empathy isn't exactly in the DSM.
True.
They used to say this place wasn't a prison.
Well, maybe they were trying to keep you safe.
Guess so. Whatever the reason, the end result was prison bars. I took a fork in here one time and hid it under my mattress. Just 'cause, fuck you.
Residents must adhere to their assigned schedules at all times and are not permitted to loiter in the dormitory outside of designated free time. Glass and silverware are to remain in the canteen and do not bring these into the dormitory. Non-resident guests are not permitted in the dormitory. Lights out at 9 p.m. every evening, no music, no TV, no screen time after lights out. Failure to adhere to all these rules results in disciplinary actions. Damn. It's like fucking military or prison.
They should have stenciled the same thing on all of us.
Property of Oregon.
Do you really feel like you were their property?
We didn't belong to anyone else, did we?
Fancy.
Everyone had one good outfit. We wore them to meet the parents.
Did it help?
Kinda think you already know the answer to that question. I remember the kid who put this here. Sadie? Sally. Something with an S?
You were friends at first, right?
Way at first. Then I freaked out on her and she was done with me. Just like everyone else.
Ace kind of sounds like Plague Inc. Oh, okay. Yeah, I can see where you think that. Yeah. I need to get back to trying to finish all the cures. I played that a little while back. Played the cure version of it. Beat like the first three or four cures.
Well, there are my strings.
So many games,
so
little time.
Where's my guitar? I don't understand. Why can't I have my guitar?
We've been over this, Alex. Your guitar stays in the rec room. You can play it during free time.
That's bullshit. I don't need it in the fucking rec room. I need it when I'm stuck in the fucking dorms.
Alex, that's enough. Maybe we'll just take away your guitar privileges entirely, if that's what you prefer.
You can't do that!
Is that everything? I think so. Well, apparently disabling my follower alerts has prevented the Haas bot from following my channel tonight. I've not seen a single follow from one of those bots. So I'm gonna leave that, my follower alerts off for a while until that fucking bot account plague is dealt with by Twitch. Hello?
She's been through so much. I just don't know if we're prepared for a troubled girl. It says here she's sensitive. What does that mean?
Means fuck you.
I wonder why she's never found a home before. I'm sure she's a sweet girl, but she's not for us.
She's awfully old, isn't she?
This is the kid that's been in all those fights, right?
I want to help. I really do, but there's just something
off.
Broken. Wrong.
With her.
Sorry.
Why?
You need to see it.
See what? That nobody picked me?
Nobody picked you. Nobody picked you. Nobody wanted you. Mom died. Dad left. I bailed. You couldn't keep us together.
It was my job to keep us...
You were 11 years old. You were 11 years old. You were a kid, Alex. Let it go. People leave. Life gets hard. Sometimes it's a big shit sandwich. Make it better. Be angry at Dad. Miss Mom. Hell, be angry at me. But don't give up.
Facts.
No one gets to tell you what you're worth. And no one can take your life away. Fight.
I'm not sure I...
You have a gift. It's something you don't even understand. You can change the world. Make it better. Now get up.
What?
Get up and fight.
So she survived? She's pretty banged up. How do you survive a fall like that? Seriously. Damn. Now it's dark. Must turn lights off. Too dark for me to turn those off so I don't have a glare. Do I seriously still have my phone in my pocket? Nope. Matches! Oh yeah, I grabbed those a long time ago. Matches burn pretty quick, though. and go along. Oh, there's a lantern. Okay. That works. The long dark. I'm just gonna leave those lights off for the rest of the night. Not sure how much longer I'm streaming anyways, so it's fine.
It's me.
So, I'm guessing Jed just fucking
I've
missed.
I've got to find a way out of here.
Me? He didn't actually hit me with this shot. Just made me flinch enough to fall down the shaft. That's my guess.
No more ladder. Not that I'd be much good at climbing.
Eh. Actually, I think this is the perfect place to cut it for tonight, because I don't want to play this for another hour. So, Twitch and YouTube, both y'all have a good one. I'll be back again tomorrow. I might actually be finishing this tomorrow. So, YouTube, that's it. Wait, why didn't that...
All around the stag, okay. This plant, the stalker chased the bandit. The stalker thought 'twas all in fun. Pop goes the bandit.
So yeah. So see you in the next stream, next video, and all that. Excuse me. Have a good night. And yeah, stay safe out there. Oh, and of course,
lick, lick, lick my balls.